Now, please, please, let me advise you. As a young man, as a young woman, grow large in your spirit. Grow very large. Give yourself to fasting. Give yourself to prayer now.
It means you do the natural, supernatural. Mount up with wings like evil, you do the supernatural, naturally. That's the proof that you have found grace. You do the supernatural naturally, and you do the natural supernaturally. Now, let me tell you a story. I want to tell you this story because Apostle Paul told it in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 1. Turn your Bible quickly. Second Corinthians chapter 1. Turn your Bible. Verse 8. For we would not, brethren, have you ignorant of our trouble which came to us in Asia, that we were pressed out of measure above strength, in so much that we despaired even of life. But we had the sentence of death in ourselves. Why? That we should not trust in ourselves, but in God, which raiseth the dead. Now, this is a testimony, and I want to explain it. Because a normal man will not submit to God. You see, a fallen man will not submit to God. Because Adam modeled the example of rebellion. In fact, heaven believes that what human beings are good at doing is to rebel. And that was why the first kingdom message that was ever preached was repent. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. When you find a human being that submits to God, it's because God conquered him. It wasn't his choice to submit. But God put him on a journey to Asia. He said, brethren, I know there are many things you have forgotten, but there's something I don't want you to forget. The peril that came to us in Asia. We despaired of life. We prayed to die. Have you ever been there? I know some of you have been there. We prayed to die. The strain was intense, and life did not make meaning anymore. And then Paul now said, when spiritual knowledge came to him, he now said it was not because God wanted us to die. He allowed us to go through all of those trials in Asia because he did not want us to trust in ourselves, but to trust in God that raises the dead. This is a spiritual dealing that God gives to anyone that has any true business to do in his kingdom. He will stretch you. Oh, you are living cool. He will blow you. Yes, he will do that. And he will do that for positive reasons. He will do that because he wants to bring you to a point where you see that your wisdom is not strong enough. He will do that until he brings you to a point where you see that your understanding is not wise enough. He will do that until he brings you to a point where you see that your intelligence is not deep enough. He will show you the futility of your wisdom, the futility of your strength, the futility of your capacity, and the reason why he renders you naked like that is not because he wants to display your shame, is because he wants you not to trust in yourself, but in the God that can raise the dead. It is only men that have come to this point that are now willing to look to the hills from whence cometh their help. So I came to tell you a story. You don't need to go all the way under God's hand of discipline before you find out that you are insufficient. Even right there that you are sitting on that seat, you can say, oh, I understand the riddle now. I understand what you are trying to say through all the many trials that I was subjected to. You just wanted me to know that my wisdom cannot win this one. And that was the lesson of Asia. Paul lived with the lesson of Asia all through his ministry, all through his life. There are some lessons you can forget. but not the lesson of Asia, because you were stripped of trust in yourself so that you can trust in the God that raises the dead. I think I need to stop there today. That's number one. So when you see the prayer of a man who understands his incapacity is different from the prayer of a man that is just, you know, I say, okay, you know, I got 2 cars packed and I just got a second master's degree. Yes, when I look on the street, I'm the only one that has a doctorate on the street. So I'm the luminary in this community. Glory, glory to God. And then when we have finished boasting, they will now add. When someone is preaching and the person is trying to advertise himself, how that, you know, you know, this one has not been to Asia. He's a good spokesman. He speaks well. But God has not sent him. Because God will not send a man that is sufficient in himself. He took off. He absconded from the school of the spirit. He has no name in glory. Demons don't know him. If he cries out at sickness, in fact, the person might die. But when I rise from the ashes of my dying in prayer, my voice might be gone. My strength might be taken away. But in that crack of my voice, if I say Jesus, life will come out of my ashes. It was the journey I had to travel in search of my help. Oh my God, we need help. In the moment of time, I want you to exercise your spirit in search of help. We need his help. In order to overturn the fortunes of the body of Christ in this land, this is a very spiritual nation. And that's why you will need something more than English talking to disarm the altar of the Sangoma. It's like Egypt, where the language, the dialect they understand is the supernatural. And if we are going to make any gains for the gospel in these lands, it will be because a new breed without greed rises. A radical opposition against unrighteousness begins to emerge. Something that is altogether a manifestation of a new creation.
Now, please, let me advise you. As a young man, as a young woman, grow large in your spirit. Grow very large. Give yourself to fasting. Give yourself to prayer now.